Hello there. At last I've got a nodal device that actually assembled and probably will work. If you read the rest of the thread preceding this, it'll show you the various stages to get up to this point where I've actually got an assembled one. It's quite a simple device. So this is. It's mounted on a ball head. I removed the top of the camera mount off the ball, this ball head, and replaced it with a disc here so I could mount the base plate for the nodal device. Also, because it's, you have to get it so you can manage to set it level. I've got a small bubble level fitted into the head, into the moving plate there, indexing plate. So there's indexing. There is two indexing screws. Where they've got a spring-loaded ball on them, the base plate has got indents in it, an outer circle with 24, an inner circle with 12, giving you 15 and 30 degree step-ins. You can use them each one on its own, or you can use them both together, which will give you an intermediate step-in of 10 degrees. What you do is take a shot and index round to the next thing. Depending on what lens you've got on, depends what stepping you use. You've also got an adjustment here on to move them out the vertical arm, so you can move it in and out to for whatever camera you've got on, so you can get the centre of the lens over this pivot point. And on the cross arm, you've got adjustments here to get the nodal point of the lens, and also you've got a plunger, a spring-loaded plunger that fixes into the arm, and you can get step-ins, 15 degree step-ins all the way around. To mount the camera, it's quite straightforward, like that, lock it in. If you're going to set it up to start, you would actually set it up looking through the viewfinder, so the centre of the lens lines up with the centre of this screw, and you just this back and forwards until you get that happy, you've got that point set. It's not got to be absolutely spot on, but as close as you can get it. And then what you do then is you move it around here, and then you go through a procedure where you can actually put a couple of pegs spacing out, and by moving the head you can get the nodal point of the lens and set this carriage across to wherever you think that point is. There is some tables which give you, people have calculated the distances out already, so all you have to do is just measure from the centre to the centre of the mounting screw to get those distances, and you can set them, and you can, they're quite easy to do actually. There's a little video on another site that shows you that on YouTube. So now we've got an indexing head, we can use it to take images, stepping around, or at another level, go around again, so we can get a multi-layered panorama. That's it. Thank you. Okay. Bye. Loosening off this indexing screw so the ball's disengaged, the head is then free to rotate, very free to rotate, there's no backlash, play, slop or anything. It's got a thrust bearing in here, a 60mm diameter thrust bearing, and a ball race, and they work together to ensure that the thing rotates very easily and without any play or resistance. Okay. You could mount your camera and you could film or track something in one plane very, very easily. Rotating, you can obviously bring it up, down, or you can disengage this altogether and you've got a completely free one, so you can track something just by moving the whole thing like a free gimbal. Okay. Apart from using it as a nodal head, where you've got indexing in that plane and indexing in this plane, or using it for panning, where you've got free movement there and free movement there, or fixed movement, whichever you want. You can also remove this vertical mount arm altogether, eventually. And replace it with just a quick release mount. I can figure out how to do it. You've got some adjustment that way. You can actually use it for doing panoramas in the landscape fashion, just without the other part of the head on. You can bring it on here. Just find that, put the nodal point through the lens there, and that, so that, right, and you can do it, you can index in the landscape as well, quite simply. You can also, I'll remove this to show you what's underneath. There is two cup washers here, so the cups fit, the dish sides are facing away from each other. A shoulder screw, a nice surface on it. There's a bearing, ball race that fits in here. Nice fit. That goes through. And mounts into here. And in here, there's a recess in the bottom plate for a thrust bearing. Sits in the bottom of there. And there's two rows of indents, as you can see now, in a row now to row there. To reassemble the head, it's quite simple. Refit the bearing, pin through, bring the two parts together, fasten the screw up, doesn't have to be tight, well it doesn't have to be tight, but it doesn't have to be over tight. Just take all that out, nip it up, not too tight, get the rotation, all works a treat. There you go, that's it. Right, this is a different device I've got to use in a different head. So I like to use a three-way head. I have a number of these floating about, the same model. They're quite easy to do, they're adjustable in two planes, and also you can pan round as well, so they're quite handy. So I'm just going to show you a small nodal head plate I made for this one. It's it can only be used in landscape fashion. You have the nodal distance set out between where it mounts in the tripod head, between there, between the central pivot point and there. So you just mount your camera on at the nodal point distance, and you're away. To set it up, I've got a head here that allows me to level it up. So if I level that up, level the head up, right, then I can set a small level on here just to make sure that these are set correctly, and quickly lock that one and that one. So now when I rotate it, I know that it's horizontal. Okay, so I can fit the camera there, and all I have to do is make sure that the nodal point of the lens is over the rotating pivot point on the tripod and I'm away. And to use this one, I just index. Make sure you get plenty of overlap, and you can either use the marks on here, or you can just use live view if you've got live view on, or you can just guesstimate it. I just guesstimate it, go around, make sure you've got plenty of overlap, and you've got it. Very simple panoramic head. Easy to take on and off, so you use that one on a pan and tilt head, and the other one, the other video shows it with the on one of the ball head, custom made for the ball head. Thank you.